I'm Joni, and you're watching a webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking on YouTube. I'm here today at the folks' place where I'm going to cook up some duck. I've been asking my twin brother Jim for a while now when he hunts duck to please bring me some, and I was fortunate enough he went hunting at Tule Lake and he brought me some beautiful duck. Stay tuned and see what I'm going to cook up today. Of the ingredients I'm using today, of course the most important is duck, and this is fresh wild duck. We've got some real beauties here. They're about 2.5 to 3 pounds. I'm also using celery, some Fuji apples, diced onion, dried red tart cherries, and butter. My mom and I discussed various ways to do the recipes today, whether we wanted to have apples or plums or pears, and we decided on this one and add some red tart cherries. These have been cleaned on the inside, the feathers, the heads, and the legs removed. They've been dry plucked, and in order to do it easily, I oftentimes use a pair of yellow rubber gloves so that you can pull them off. It holds the grip. I'm going to probably clean them up just a little more and dry pluck some of the little pin feathers off of them. I'm fortunate enough to have fresh duck to work with today. When I finish cleaning up the feathers on this one, I'm going to rinse them, pat them dry inside and outside so that my finished body looks like this. If you used a frozen duck, you should let it defrost in the refrigerator slowly for a couple of days and then prepare it. Mom and I have been discussing about what we want to stuff them with today, and we decided to use the red tart cherries. I have 1/4 cup for every duck, so I have 1 cup of red tart cherries. I have 2 Fuji apples, which I cut in half, and then I took each half and took them and cut them into wedges. So each of the ducks will have a half apple. For the onion, I did the onion quartered and did it into a wedge shape. I'll loosen those up when I put it in the cavity. And 1 celery stalk per duck. So 4 celery stalks, 1 large yellow onion, 2 Fuji apples, and 1 cup of the red tart cherries. I will be taking and using butter to grease the inside of the cavities. Here's 1 duck with the ingredients that I need to put in for 1 serving. I'm going to take some butter and rub it inside the cavity. Then I'll add 1 of the cut celery stalks, 1/2 apple, 1/4 of the onion, a wedge, and 1/4 cup of the dried tart cherries. The duck has been thoroughly dried and it's been room temperature. I rubbed the inside of the duck with butter. I filled the cavity loosely with onion, chopped apple, celery, and dried tart cherries. I have the 4 ducks ready. Mostly they're mallard and teal. And Mom suggested that I put some wine in when I cook, so I'm going to add some white Zinfandel, and I'll place these 4 in a 12-inch Camp Chef oven. I preheated the oven and it's right about 350. I want it to be around 325 for a slow cook. They're ready to go back on the heat. I poured some white Zinfandel over them. If you don't want to use a wine, you can always add about 1/2 cup of some low salt chicken broth or even water. I just want to get a little bit of moisture in there. They are rubbed inside with butter, and then I also rub the outside skin so that they would brown up. I'm going to bake them at 325 now for about 1.5 hours. I'll probably have 1 coal change. Okay, it's at the 1 hour mark and I'm changing coals and checking them. I think by the looks of them and the temperature that I checked, they probably need to go at least 20 to 30 more minutes. And here's the finished product, Dutch oven wild duck.
That's today's webisode. I'm Joni. I want to give a shout out to my twin brother Jim. He oftentimes provides us with the seafood and wild game that we feature in our webisodes, everything from A to V, abalone to venison. Thanks, Jim. Appreciate all the game that you give us over the years. Until the next time, happy trails to you. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.